What's up everyone? Notepad++ is a free text editor for Windows with additional features that are not there in Windows native text editor. In this video, I'll be sharing tricks that I regularly use while using Notepad++ to save time and effort. So without further ado, let's get started. Using macros, you can record repetitive steps and run it using a single click. We want to transform this ordered list of words into a comma-separated list with each name inside single quotes. To do that, go to macros and click on start recording. Notepad++ will now record all our steps in the sequence we execute them. Once we have executed all these steps, go to macro and click stop recording. We can playback the macros we just recorded multiple times by clicking playback from the menu. I would instead go and click on this option to run it multiple times. You can run it X number of times by giving it a number here. I want to run it till the end of the file, so I'll select that and click run. Done. Quick and easy. Multi-select editing allows you to edit text at several locations simultaneously. I am looking to make identical edits on line 1 and 3. One way is to type it multiple times. Another way is to use multi-select edit. To enable this feature, go to settings, then preferences. Go to editing and click this checkbox to enable multi-edit settings. Now close this window. Now while holding control, you can select multiple locations and make edits in one go. Using vertical selection, you can select text as if it were a column in a spreadsheet. Let's see how. I'm trying to add an article ahead of these words. I can either make the changes one by one or use vertical select. To make vertical selection, hold the Alt key and drag the cursor vertically using your mouse. Now, any edits you would make will apply to the entire column. Let's say I want to add a serial number in front of these lines. To do that, make a vertical selection. Go to Edit and then Column Editor. I want to start the numbering from 1 and increase it by 1. Let's hit OK. Column Editor has added serial numbers to each line. Now let's make it look more like a list. And done. Read-only mode is exactly what it sounds like. To make sure you don't end up making changes to a file, right-click on Tab and click on Read-only option. Notice how file icon is grayed out. I'm unable to make any changes to the document. To make the file editable again, right-click on File tab and click Read-only option to come out of read-only mode. I can now make changes to the document. You can use Begin and Select to select content based on line numbers. Let's say I want to select text from line number 5 to, say, line number 25. I will place the cursor at the location where I want the selection to begin. Then go to Edit and click Begin and Select option. Notepad++ will mark your current cursor location as starting point of the selection. Let's now go to line number 25. I want to make selection till here, so I'll click and place the cursor here. I will now go back to Edit and then click on Begin and Select. Notepad++ will now mark the current cursor location as ending point of the selection and will select the text from the beginning to the end point. Summary is helpful when you want to check the number of characters, words, and lines that are there in the document you're working on. To view document summary, go to View and click on Summary. This will show summary of a file, like the number of characters, words, and lines. It also shows characters selected right now. Usually, same details are present on the status bar of Notepad++. You can extend Notepad++ capabilities by using plugins. Plugins are small and big additions to Notepad++ to extend its functionality. If you like the videos I make and you want to see more such content, consider subscribing the channel. See you in another video. Till then, stay safe. Thanks for watching.